From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Nearly 4 months after a 22-year-old Lewiston woman went missing, the search for her body continued today. Christiana Fesmeyer went missing in July. Members of the Maine Warden Service and State Police are searching the Lewiston, Auburn, and Mechanic Falls areas for Fesmeyer. State police tell News 8 officers fanned out in 21 different locations. Today's search started around 6 o'clock this morning. The Warden Service is using Lewiston High School as a command post in the search for her body.
We're just taking the information that the investigators gave us, and we try to come up with areas that we feel that somebody would dump a body, and it's using the same things that we've worked before in other cases that have worked, and we're trying that today.
Last month, 30-year-old Buddy Robinson was arrested and charged with her murder. Last week, Robinson pleaded not guilty in an Androscoggin County court. Court documents say Robinson drowned Fesmeyer in a bathtub in her Lewiston apartment, then dumped her body in an unknown wooded area. A motive hasn't been released. Possible federal funding cuts to Amtrak are worrying supporters of the Downeaster passenger train service serving Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts. The U.S. House Transportation, Housing, and Urban Development Appropriation Subcommittee proposal would slash Amtrak funding. It also prohibits the use of federal funds to support any state-funded intercity passenger rail trains. The nonprofit volunteer organization, Train Riders Northeast, has sent resolutions to all the communities along the rail asking them to oppose any Amtrak federal funding decreases. The Downeaster runs from Portland, Maine to Boston. It will soon expand to the Midcoast area, serving Freeport and Brunswick. With chillier temperatures now upon us, some athletes managed to get in a triathlon today. Indoors, the Northern York County Family YMCA hosted the 2011 Fall Classic Indoor Triathlon. This competition involves 20 minutes of swimming, stationary biking, and running on a treadmill. Ages range from 10 to 70. Each participant's distance was calculated.
Here, it's, you know, whatever you can do in that time. So it's very friendly for people who are just trying things out. You know, if you can only do so much in the pool, that's okay, because you can always make it up on the bike. And you only have to do about 20 minutes of each event, so it's very doable.
Proceeds go to the YMCA's scholarship program. The Northern York County Family YMCA also hosts an indoor triathlon in the spring as well. Some people in Old Orchard Beach are lending a hand to those in need, especially with the holidays right around the corner. Those with OOB 365 held a food drive today at McDonald's Garage. The goal was to fill up the entire truck with food and bring it to the town's food pantry. They're hoping to get enough food to help families out for at least the next 2 months. It's help so many could use.
And we're going to try to raise funds and raise donations today. They gave away 400 food for 400 families last month, so in Old Orchard Beach, only Old Orchard Beach families, so the need is great.
Those with OOB 360 are hoping to deliver the food tomorrow. Thank you for watching News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson.